Explain to us how this deal came about. Who asked, who approached whom?
Actually, Bombardier approached us this summer. And again, when we had a good, as you know, it's an opportunity we looked at in the past, and we this deal at the time, the stars were not aligned, and we thought that this time was a different one for many reasons, particularly the fact that the aircraft has been certified, the C-Series has been certified, it entered into service, good feedback from the customers, and so on our side, also at Airbus side, many of the hurdles that were existing 2 years ago, namely certification of A350, now are past and behind us. So we thought, again, it was the right time to finally do this important deal.
The way it's been reported, initially Airbus will not be injecting any cash into this venture, but it will be liable for funding going forward. This has been a project from Bombardier, which they've spent a lot of money on. There's been a lot of cost overruns. Is there a limit to how much Airbus will be investing?
There's no limit on how much Airbus will be investing, but again, the deal is at closing a cash-free, debt-free deal. And in the 2 years following the closing, Bombardier will be in a position to invest every year $350 million cash. So the cash put forward by Airbus during that period should be extremely limited.
So going forward, as I understand it from what you just said, Bombardier would actually be contributing more cash in the future than Airbus would be?
For the first years of the venture, whilst I think we are still managing the current situation, yes, and then I think moving forward again, we will little by little get full control of the joint venture. We'll start with a 50.01 control shares majority once the closing is done, with roughly 30%, as you know, for Bombardier and 20% for Quebec. After some years, we'll have a call on the Quebec shares, and then after some more years, we have a call on the Bombardier shares to go up to progressively 70 and 100%.
So you, as I understand what you just said, you have an option in the out years to go up to as high as 70%, not more?
No, 70% as a first step with taking the Quebec, a call on the Quebec 20% shares, and then we'll have some years later a call on the 30% Bombardier share, getting ourselves to 100%.
So as we all know, one of the issues with the C-Series has been a trade dispute with the United States and imposition of tariffs on these Canadian, until now Canadian, planes. As I understand it, the final assembly now will be done in Mobile, Alabama. Do you know that that will take care of the tariff problem? Does that take care of the U.S. trade sanction?
We believe it will. We believe it will, because there will be no import of an aircraft into U.S. soil, since the aircraft will be manufactured on U.S. soil. So the idea, yes, indeed, is to maintain the FAL in Mirabel, Canada, but also to build a new one near our Mobile facility, which is performing very well for Airbus, which is we're very happy with the quality of the aircraft coming out of this FAL, and our customers are as well. And so we thought we could also take advantage of the people there and their competence and build a FAL there for the U.S. market.
Have you or your representatives had discussions with representatives of the U.S. government to confirm that interpretation, so that you are reasonably confident that this will take care of the tariff?
We didn't, for confidentiality reasons, we didn't interact with representative of U.S. government at that stage. However, what we've done, and Bombardier has done the same, was obviously to work a lot with top U.S. law firms and get legal opinion to the effect that indeed that lead us to believe and be confident in the fact that building a FAL in the U.S. indeed is a solid solution.
How much of this was an offensive move, in the sense of you're moving forward with your business, you're expanding your business? How much of it was defensive, in the sense that there were largely reported rumors that the Chinese might step in and actually acquire the C aircraft? Was this partly to keep China from acquiring it?
No, I think again it's a long story. We've been trying to get access to the C series a long time. It's not the first time we're trying. With or without the Chinese. And I think for what we see for ourselves is a double opportunity. It's an opportunity to extend our footprint It's an opportunity to get access to a market to which effectively we have no access today. We haven't sold any A319 aircraft in the past 5 years. We see this market as a very significant one. We're talking 6,000 aircraft. And also this market is, I would say, less crowded maybe than the upper segment of the single-aisle market. So we believe it's an opportunity for us to have basically access to a market with what we believe is the best product to serve this market.
Should we expect you to become more acquisitive in the future?
Not necessarily. I think here again, it's an old story that finally came to fruition. I think we will be looking in other fields, possibly of acquisition in different domains, but there's no rush, and again, not in the immediate future.
Oh, what other domains?
Oh, it could be again. I think today we are looking at I think any industrial company today is looking at how can we improve in different domains like digitalization, like deep learning. We do have a solid partnership that are helping us to. And you may have heard about the Skywise initiative we have with the airlines, again helping us to make the best possible use of digital to serve our customers. And I think it's an area where we want to grow.
As we know, there's been an ongoing trade dispute, really, between Boeing on the one hand and Airbus on the other. Boeing came out with a statement this morning, right quick, saying, well, this is basically two state-subsidized aircraft manufacturers getting together, and they're going to continue to resist this. How does this position you with respect to Boeing?
Well, I think again, there has been ongoing discussions and with Boeing for many, many years, and there's been ongoing debate in front of WTO between the EU and the US on that matter. I think where we Airbus place the competition is on the product. One of the reasons why we step in into that deal with Bombardier is because we had many customers asking us to step in as well. I mean, it's of course the first one to initiate the demarche were Bombardier, but clearly we had many U.S. customers in particular that were very concerned about being faced with basically a monopoly for aircraft between 100 and 150 seaters, and I don't think a monopoly is good for competition by definition.